Good morning, Mr. Anderson. How are you?
Hi there. Good.
Good. My name is Amanda. I'm your nurse today.
Hi, Amanda.
How are you doing today?
Not bad.
Yeah? What brings you in?
Just routine checkup.
Routine checkup. Okay, I'm going to start with some vital signs, all right?
Oh, yeah.
Looks like you're eating on the go. Is this your snacks for the day?
Yeah.
Is this a typical meal for you?
Well, I spend a lot of time, windshield time, sitting down in the truck. Well, that's my extra salt.
Oh, okay. It's for emergencies, right?
That's right.
All right, let me get some vital signs. How have you been feeling lately?
Oh, not bad.
Good. All right, let's see what your blood pressure is looking like. Do you know what you normally run?
Oh, somewhere, they said 90 over 140 something. I don't know.
Okay, that sounds backwards, but we're going to go with it. All right, let's see what it is. Wow, looks like you're 148 over 88.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's pretty high.
That's
Did
bad.
You know you were that high?
I knew maybe, but I didn't know it was bad. That's
All right,
bad.
That's what we call hypertension. I'm going to bring your doctor in and she's going to explain that to you, okay?
Okay. Hi there.
Hi, Mr. Anderson. How you doing?
Doing okay, doctor.
Okay, my name is Tochi. And I went through your chart, and your nurse also told me your blood pressure is high, so, you know, it's been coming up. So, you're pretty hypertensive, okay? So, I have to consult with your nutritionist, your nurse educator, going to have them come in and talk about treatment options for you, okay?
Hypertension is a silent killer. Most people go without signs or symptoms of hypertension unless they are checked through blood pressure reading. A normal blood pressure reading is below 120 over 80. Pre-hypertension ranges from 120 to 139 over 80 to 90. Stage 1 hypertension is from 140 to 159 over 90 to 99. And stage 2 hypertension is anything above 160 over 100.
Signs and symptoms of hypertension can include dizziness, double vision, and headache. But oftentimes it goes undetected and can only be diagnosed with a blood pressure reading. Risk factors for hypertension include obesity, high salt intake, alcohol use, lack of physical activity, smoking, stress, age, race, family history, and gender. If diagnosed with hypertension, your physician may prescribe medications and recommend lifestyle changes to reduce your blood pressure. Medications include ACE inhibitors, beta blockers, and calcium channel blockers. Lifestyle changes include quitting smoking, decreasing alcohol consumption, maintaining a healthy weight, increasing physical activity 30 minutes a day, 5 days a week, and eating a healthy diet. Dietary approaches to stop hypertension, also known as DASH, is a lifelong approach to healthy eating designed to help treat or prevent high blood pressure. It encourages you to reduce sodium intake and eat a variety of foods rich in nutrients to help lower your blood pressure. Eating more fruits and vegetables and low-fat dairy foods, cutting back on foods high in saturated fat, cholesterol, and trans fat, eating more whole grains, fish, poultry, and nuts, and limiting sodium, sweets, sugary drinks, and red meats to help reduce your blood pressure naturally.
How have you been doing with that diet?
Better.
Good?
Healthy choices.
Yeah, no more salt?
No.
Good. Well, it looks like your blood pressure is 115 over 72.
Really?
Yeah, let me bring your doctor in and let her know. How are you doing?
Cool.
Hi, Mr. Anderson.
Dr. Tochi, he's down to 115 over 72.
Oh, good. So it seems like the medication is working, the diet is working, so that's pretty good.
You quit smoking?
Yes, ma'am.
Awesome.
Hopefully we'll get you out of the medication pretty soon, okay? Just keep working on the diet and exercise.
Okay.
Prevention is key.